Good day everybody. In this video, I would like to explain how to read and understand acceleration response spectrum. And I would like to start with the records from the recent earthquake that happened in Turkey last week. It was very, very strong earthquake. And this is the data that shows peak ground acceleration. It also shows velocity and changes in displacement during earthquake. So this data was recorded by a seismograph, which was very close to the fault. It's about 3 kilometers, and it was recorded in the north-south direction. So if we look at the numbers, you will see that the peak ground acceleration was extremely high. It's 1.95 Gs, and velocity was 0.68 meters per second. And that it produced displacement of 22 centimeters, so it was very, very high. So all this data is collected from the recent report presented by NTUA in Greece, and this report is freely available on the UHGS website. So that's where I found it. So now look at this graph, which is the topic of today's presentation. So this is called acceleration response spectrum, but we can do the same response spectrum for velocity and displacement. I will teach you how we get these numbers. So first of all, let's see that here we have natural period that we measure in seconds. And here on this axis, we have acceleration in Gs. So why this is very important and why do you think people use it for design of building? It's because each building has its own natural period, and we can estimate this natural period for each particular building, and then we can look at the acceleration spectrum and see what type of building will be subjected to the either highest acceleration or highest velocity or displacement during a particular earthquake. So the way that we get this spectrum is we assume a single degree of freedom model. So it's linear one. So we select the mass of the model. So let's say that the mass is M. And this model is connected to the spring. And this spring has a stiffness of K. So we also need to assume damping ratio for this particular model. And for earthquakes, for earthquake engineering, damping ratio is usually 5%, the one that was assumed. And what we do next is we select earthquake. And in this case, we select this earthquake and we select this acceleration record. And then we're going to excite this model with these records of acceleration. So that's the record acceleration. And we're going to measure maximum acceleration that would, this model would produce, right? And then we're going to record it against the natural period of this model. So to calculate natural period of this model, we're going to use this formula. So this is T, we have 2 times pi square root of mass divided by K. So that will be one value on this graph. Let's say, for example, point here. Then what we're going to do next, we will keep the same mass. Mass is constant, but we're going to change K. So we increase K. We're going to estimate a new natural period for this slightly modified model. And after that, we're going to excite this model to the same earthquake motion. And here again, we're going to use acceleration records. And we're going to calculate the maximum acceleration for this newly modified model. And for example, that will be point here. And then we're going to connect it. So that's how we get this response acceleration spectrum. And in this example, you see 3 different lines. So each for different direction, east, west, north, south, and vertical direction. So now let's do exercise and see how we can estimate natural period for different buildings. I selected 2 buildings. One is 1-story building, and the other one is 800 meters tall tower. So just wanted to give you two extreme examples, very small building and very, very tall tower. And then we see what is going to be natural periods for each of the building. And we can actually look at the spectrum at this graph and see which of the building will be subjected to the higher acceleration during this particular earthquake that happened in Turkey. Okay, so let's start with the one-story building. We already have the data here provided, which is the weight of the building and the stiffness. So we just need to estimate it using the formula on the right-hand side, 2 times 3.14. Because we're using weight and not mass, we're going to divide weight, which is 1.5. We're going to divide it by 9.81, which is G. And then we're going to divide it by the stiffness, which is 250 meganewtons per meter. So make sure that these two values have the same units, right? And then we will estimate that the natural period of this one-story building will be 0.15 seconds. So now let's do the same exercise for the other building, which is much taller. And then it has a much greater mass or weight. So, but we're gonna still use the same formula, which is 2 times 3.14. Here we have a square root of 6,000. Here we have 9.81, which is gravity acceleration, and divide by the stiffness of this building, which is 200. So it will give us about 10.9 seconds. So if we now look at this acceleration spectrum for the earthquake, we'll see that one-story building should be somewhere, somewhere here. 0.15 somewhere here, and 800 meters tower will be even further down on the right-hand side. So for this particular earthquake, you will see that smaller buildings, one-story, maybe two or three-story buildings, will be subjected to much greater acceleration. You see, this is big acceleration for these few-story buildings compared to the very tall buildings, 800 meters tall tower, which is natural somewhere here, should be 10. So this is how this spectrum is used for building design. So if we know particular earthquake that is going to happen, we can estimate this acceleration response spectrum for different natural periods. And then we can look at the type of buildings that we're going to design in that particular area. And then just make sure that those buildings don't have natural periods which will be subjected to the highest value of acceleration during that particular design earthquake. Or if we still need to build that type of building, we need to think about a better design that will prevent these buildings from collapsing during earthquake. Well, that's it for today. Thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day. Bye.